Okay. Has anyone ever accidentally seen you naked? Yes! This is so embarrassing. So on tour, it's embarrassing how many times this has happened. Okay. And this was the most humbling anytime I think for a second that I'm the shit. Okay. Anytime. I swear God comes in and just let someone see me naked on accident. And then I am just like plummeted humble.
This is Up in Country, powered by vLiveCast. I'm your host, Sue Bonzell, bringing you rising country artists direct from Nashville. Now let's get this show started.
She has recorded songs with Jimmie Allen and Pat Green, and she has her debut album out. I am so excited. Abby Anderson is here. Hey, Abby.
Hi, Sue.
Oh, my gosh.
What's up, everybody?
I'm thrilled to have you here. Now, I love your music. We have so much to talk about because, I mean, you started one place, you've done these songs with Jimmie Allen and Pat Green. Like, that's like big time. How did that come about, working with them?
People are just really nice and think of me sometimes. I don't know, Jimmy's a dear friend of mine, and he called me up and was like, I want to do this cover of Shallow. I keep hearing your voice in it, and I'd like to think I'm a pretty smart person, so I said yes, obviously.
Yes.
And then with someone like Pat Green, he's a fellow Texan. I've been a fan of his for a long time. We had mutual friends, so that's kind of how that came about.
I love it, and they're amazing songs. I mean, they're wonderful. So now, tell me about, like, growing up, you have a pretty big family, right?
Yeah.
So, like, what was that like, and how did you get into country music and really start cultivating that?
So I'm the second oldest of seven kids.
Wow.
So there's six girls in my family, one boy. And again, like, I was born in San Antonio, growing up in Texas. I think, you know, country music and music in general is just a big part of the culture there.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people play, a lot of people sing, especially in my family. So I just always grew up around it. And it's always what I wanted to do.
So is everybody in your family musical? Did you guys play music together when you were growing up? Yeah.
I'd say everyone in my family is very musical. All my sisters play piano.
Oh, nice.
Everybody sings together.
Oh, that is so cool. So you have one brother.
One brother.
And he survived.
He's a spoiled brat. He's fine. He's doing better than surviving.
He's just fine. Was he being mothered by all of y'all?
Oh,
because,
yeah.
You know, because that's what you kind of do, right?
Oh, yeah. He has like I think he's going to have a very unhealthy expectation for women in general because he got doted on and... Yeah, so I'm sorry. To all the ladies out there, I'm very sorry.
But how lucky is he, though?
He's so lucky.
Right? Come he on. Has a unique experience.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we got you here doing the country music and everything. Now, how old were you when you moved to Nashville? You were pretty young, right?
I was, yeah. So I decided to move out here when I was 17. And just kind of decided, like, okay, school's great. That's fine. But I kind of know what I want to do. So I was really lucky. My parents let me just... head on out here.
They're like, okay, we're down.
Yeah.
I love it. So, okay, so I saw a mention of the 615 house.
Yeah.
So I want you to tell us, like, what that is and what kind of role that's played in your career.
Oh, totally. Yeah. So 615 house is basically, I'm sure we're all familiar with TikTok here. It's kind of like changed and, you know, rejuvenated everything in the music industry, but it's basically a whole collective group of artists in Nashville, and we all get together, make videos, sing each other's songs, sing originals, and it's an amazing platform. They've got like 2 million followers on there, so it's an awesome place to just get exposure.
Well, yeah, and then you're also able to, like you said, kind of meet some other artists
things
like that. So,
yeah.
I mean, how fun is it to get together with these other artists and like write some songs and collaborate and like tell me about some of your writing and everything.
It's a great platform because we can all use kind of each other's following, you know, and that's
absolutely
a whole source of exposure for everybody. So
now you've been on a little bit of a journey.
Yes.
So I know, and I mean, it's not an easy journey.
And
you've been really very vocal about it and kind of being open with, you know, eating disorder.
Yeah.
So like, where are you now? Like, how has that changed you and your music?
Oh my gosh. It's changed a lot. And I don't know if, and I am really open about it now because thankfully I'm healed, done with it. I don't wish an eating disorder on anybody. That's some gnarly crap. Okay. It'll mess you up pretty good.
Aww.
But I'm thankful that you know, I had that experience. I know what it's like to not listen to my intuition.
Mm-hmm.
And I know what it's like to not listen to yourself and try to please everybody else around you.
Oh, yeah.
And I look back on like the last 5 years and even that girl I was, you know, after I signed a record deal, all I was trying to do was make everyone else happy. And I think if I could go back and tell myself something, I would say you need to heal that part before you go sign a record deal, because that's just a recipe for a mess.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. So now, did you walked away from that?
I did.
Record deal, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that seems, you know, tell me about that process. Because
seems counterintuitive.
Well, yeah, because
right?
you kind of go, yeah, I'm going to Nashville. I got a record deal. Like, that's what everybody
yeah.
wants, right?
Yeah.
So what happened with that in that process? And,
yeah.
and where are you now as far as like record deal kind of
oh,
thing?
Oh, totally. No, so when I moved to town, I mean, even what's crazy is like even 7 years ago, the industry was so different.
Yeah.
And it still was like you move to town, try to get a publishing deal, get a record deal, go to country radio, you know, which is great.
Right.
That's an awesome path, too. So I was definitely had that in my mind, got a record deal, super thankful for that experience.
Yeah.
They did a lot for me, put a lot of time and money into me, and I wouldn't be here today without that experience for sure. Mm-hmm. At the same time, I think in 2020, I realized like, I was just putting out music I didn't absolutely love.
Ah, okay.
You know, which you would think as an artist, like, it's pretty stupid. Like, I recommend putting out music you really, really love. But again, like, I was stuck in that hamster wheel of just trying to please everybody.
Yeah.
And if someone else told me, you know, surrounded by people telling me, like, this will work, that won't, can't do that, do this. And it's like, yeah, when you're 19... You know?
That's true.
So
young.
I like to think I have some compassion for my younger self now. Everybody was just trying to do what they thought was
well, of
right.
Of course,
you know?
Of course. Well, and you know, when you have that team around you too, they want you to be successful
for
as
sure,
well.
For sure, for sure.
But like you said, it's kind of like that gut feeling of like.
It was a gut feeling.
You know when it's like, this is not right.
Yeah.
Like something's not right. It doesn't
and
feel
I
right.
I think like it all just kind of came to a head in 2020 when the world shut down.
Right.
And it was the first time I ever had time to like sit and think about what I wanted for the next, you know, the next years of my career.
Right.
And I realized like, I'm not happy doing what I've been doing. I'm actually kind of miserable.
Aww.
So why am I doing it?
Right. That's a good question to ask yourself. Why are you doing it? So you've kind of shifted some of the style of your music a little bit.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I like the old stuff too.
Yeah.
New stuff kind of, it's pretty snazzy.
Thank you.
Like, it's snazzy. Like, I like it. It's super catchy.
Thank you.
And that's like, that feels like more like you, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
absolutely.
This is the name of the album, Juicy.
The name of the album, Sugar Spice.
Oh, Sugar Spice. But
yeah.
The song is Juicy,
the
right?
The song on there
okay.
is called Juicy.
So
yep.
tell me about the song Juicy and,
yeah.
and what that means.
Yeah, absolutely. It means a lot of things. I think y'all can probably infer what it means off the top of your head when you hear a song called Juicy. But no, I actually wrote this last year. I'd been recovered from my eating disorder for like a year or two. And when you recover, it's a really weird mind spin because you're like you're so used to being one way physically, and then when you get healthy, like you know you're healthy but you're not used to this new body,
right.
You know, and you're like, oh, it's such a mind f, honestly. so I was writing one day with my producer and he brought up the title Juicy and my eyes just lit
like,
up and
yep.
I was like, that's my freaking song. You gotta write that. And I wrote it honestly for like all my sisters and
aww.
All the women in my family.
Right.
You know, we're all Texas, Latina, loud ass women. And I was like, I need a song for all these women in my life who have tried to be something they're not.
Nah.
And like try to fit a box that genetically we don't fit in, literally. So that's what Juicy is about for me. It's about to, like, obviously physically, but emotionally, spiritually, just being full.
Yeah.
And, like, finally listen to myself and not apologizing for being to this or
absolutely.
To that.
Absolutely. I
know?
Totally agree with you. I've done that. So I'm single, and it's kind of like, I was just talking to one of my other single friends, and it's kind of like, you know, if I'm too loud for you, then y'all are not my person.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry for you.
Yeah.
So you get to be who you are.
Absolutely.
And I love that about that. Okay, so, I mean, you've got all these accolades, too. We have to talk about this. Let's see. Pandora named you as a country artist to watch. CMT, you were CMT 18 for 2018. Mm-hmm. Next Women of Country class, you were with the Ashley McBride too.
Yeah, I mean, that's, she's a badass.
She's kind of a badass.
I love her.
Absolutely.
I love her so much.
And then you've got, you shared the stage with Kelsey Ballerini, mm-hmm. Russell Dickerson, Chase Rice, Brett Eldridge. Girl.
It feels like a long time.
That's a lot. That's a lot. And did I also hear that Marie Osmond is your mentor?
Yes, I love Miss Marie.
So how did that happen? I love that.
She, again, a friend of a friend, another mentor of mine had connected us. And we just got to talking one time. And I'd like to think I'm a student of people. And so I just annoy the hell out of her with all my questions. I can be pretty annoying with, like, how many questions I have for people. And, you know, she's an ideal person to learn from, yeah. I'd say.
She's been in the business a long, long time, yeah. And been through a lot as well. So, yeah.
Absolutely.
That's awesome. Okay, well, I know you brought your guitar.
You're ready
to play a little song
for us? Let's do it.
Okay,
absolutely.
And you're going to play Where Did All the Cowboys Go?
I will, yeah.
This is a great question. I ask myself the same thing often. All right, when we come back, Abby Anderson mm-hmm. playing her song.
What's up, everybody? I'm Abby Anderson, and this is my song, Where Did All the Cowboys Go, from my album, Sugar Spice. Here we go.
Call me old-fashioned, nostalgic or naive, but I want to know what happened to calloused hands and faded jeans. Did they ride off in the sunset, get lost in sin and tone? Can anybody tell me, does anybody know? Where did all the cowboys go, the kind of men that were walking home? Say yes, man, to your mama. Let you know how bad they want you. To step across the floor. Never let you open your own door. Get your heart running wild like a rodeo. Oh, where did all the cowboys go? Maybe they're just hiding from the girls that broke their hearts. Yeah, I would try to find them, but I don't know where to start. Where did all the cowboys go? The kind of man that would walk you home. Say yes, ma'am, to your mama. Let you know how bad they want you. To step across the floor. Never let you open your own door. Get your heart running wild like a rodeo. Oh, where did all the cowboys go? Mm-hmm. Well, did they ride off in the sunset, get lost in sin and tone? Yeah, I know you're out there somewhere, and you ain't gotta be alone. Where did all the cowboys go? The kind of man that would walk you home. Say yes, ma'am, to your mama. Let you know how bad they want you. To step across the floor. Never let you open your own door. Get your heart running wild like a rodeo.
right, Abby Anderson, where did all those cowboys go? I love it. Thank you so much for us.
Thank you.
So let's talk about the album before you go.
Yeah.
So this is Sugar Spice.
Sugar Spice.
Baby, let's. I want to hear all about it. How many songs, the whole theme, all the good things.
You got it. So it's 9 songs, short and sweet, you know. But no, this album really, I mean, this is the first time I've ever put out an album. Hey. And I wanted to keep it short and sweet because I'll be putting out music in the fall. Like, I'm just like, let's just put out more music. But I definitely wanted like an introductory project for everyone to listen to. I've put out EPs before. I've put out a lot of music before. But this is the first time I've ever really gotten to make music without having to listen to anybody else but myself.
Nice. Ooh, she's
in
charge.
Which is really, really awesome. Very creatively freeing, very fun. So honestly, we'll see, you know, it'll either be great or it's going to be terrible. I like it. So we'll see.
I think it's going to be great. I mean, just the fact of following your heart and doing what you love and like you said, making music that you love, not for anybody else.
Exactly.
Like that's, you know what, that's where your fans, they see it, they feel it, they hear it. And it's like, yep, we're all in. Yeah. We're all in for you.
Good.
So if you haven't, when is it coming out?
Actually, it comes out tonight. So today, July 15th.
Okay.
I don't know when this comes out.
All right.
So whenever this comes out, it'll probably be out.
It'll be out.
There you go. It's out. Go listen to it.
It's out now. Go listen to it on the Spotify. Download it. Go listen on Apple Music. All the things.
Mm-hmm.
And be sure to follow Abby Anderson as well. But before she leaves, we have to play my world famous game.
Okay, come on.
Truth or truth.
Oh, truth.
Are you ready? This is my world famous
game. I live that every day, either way. So
you get to, here, I'm going to take out some of these old ones. Somebody rolled that one up real good.
All right.
Okay. All right, you get to pick your question.
Wow. What have you bought that's been the biggest waste of money? Everything. There has been nothing that I have bought has been necessary or makes sense. None of it.
Did you buy anything on Amazon Prime Day?
I actually didn't.
I didn't either for the first time.
Really, I don't feel the rush to, I don't know, that stresses me out. Whenever I be like, biggest sale. It's like, it shuts me down. I'm like, it's okay. The thing that, the biggest waste of money? Oh, probably like any fancy skincare.
Oh, there you go.
It's the best stuff I've used from Walgreens. I should take that back because one day some fancy skincare line is going to be like, want to endorse me. And then I'll be, never mind.
They're going to go
I'll
back.
Be your girl, but right now.
But at the moment.
Water and soap works great.
Exactly. All natural right here. She's natural beauty. You don't even need any
You're
of that
so
stuff.
Nice.
Natural beauty right here.
All right, did I put this one
you
back
can just
in?
Put that one right there.
Okay.
We'll do another one.
Here we go. This is fun. Okay. Has anyone ever accidentally seen you naked? Yes! This is so embarrassing. So on tour, it's embarrassing how many times this has happened. Okay. And this was the most humbling anytime, I think for a second, that I'm the shit. Okay. Anytime. I swear God comes in and just lets someone see me naked on accident. And then I am just like plummeted humble. Okay. On tour, you know, things happen on tour, on accident. One night, I was about to go on stage. I was wearing a jumpsuit. And all my girls know, when you wear a jumpsuit and you gotta go pee, the whole thing has to come off. The whole thing has to come off, okay? And it was one of those where you don't have to wear a bra too.
Right.
But, so I was butt naked on the toilet, forgot to lock the door. It was one of those single family stalls. Forgot to lock the door. And one of my band members opens the door, and I just start laughing.
Like, hey.
It's just embarrassing. Like, being naked is one thing, okay? When you're naked standing up, that's hot.
Sure.
When you're naked sitting on the toilet, slunched, it was, oh my gosh. We're family now. And he immediately shuts the door, but I was, oh my gosh.
Oh,
I was just
hilarious.
Like, of course. Like, I was thinking I was too cool for a second.
For a second.
I was thinking I was pretty cool for a second, so.
Well,
there you go.
Nothing
is sacred.
This is what happens on the road. These are like the on-the-road stories that we love to hear, right?
Exactly.
Yes. Okay, one
there
more.
You go.
You can pick one
okay,
more.
Okay. These are fun. I think I like this too much. Golly. All right. If you could swap lives with anyone, who would it be? Honestly, probably a sloth. sleeping all
just
day.
Slow.
Just chilling. God, that'd be nice. Does anything eat a sloth?
That's a good question. I don't know.
I actually need to go Google. I'm sure they have predators. I don't know.
I guess. I don't know. It's a sloth.
They're just chilling in a tree. Ugh. I would love to be a sloth. I really would. I'd be a good one.
It's the napping,
that
right?
Or a bear. Yeah.
That or a bear.
Sleep all winter, man.
Exactly. Sleeping.
There you go.
Okay. All right. We got the inside scoop from Abby Anderson. I want to thank you so much for being
here. Thank you, Sue. Thank you
Great
for having
to see
me.
You. Thanks for playing the song. Yeah. We're going to do this again very soon, so we'll see you then.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks for watching Up in Country. Be sure to like and subscribe and leave us a comment. We do new episodes every Tuesday, and be sure to follow Up in Country on Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook. And you can follow me too, @SueBonzell on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok.